One of the weird things about Donald Trump's new social media company is that it is a publicly traded company, which means Donald Trump is not free to hide everything like he does with his own organization. Everything has to be public. The shareholders get to know every single secret, every single detail, and they have to be heavily involved with the decision-making of the new platform. And we learned recently that because this is a publicly traded company, of course, with Donald Trump, sitting at the very top of it and owning a good share of it, the investors, in their paperwork, in their contracts, have come up with a contingency plan, if you will. And the contingency plan explains what exactly will happen to Donald Trump's shares of the company should he go to prison. Now, unfortunately, that's the extent of what we know. We don't know what the contract says they will do with Trump's shares, or if he will even retain ownership of them if he goes to prison. But the fact that they even had to come up with a plan, hey, listen, the guy running this whole thing might end up in jail. We should probably have it in writing what's going to happen to the company if the guy running it is behind bars. I think that's a pretty telling admission from the people who have invested in this. And to be honest, this should send investors running the other way. Do you really want to put your money, put millions of dollars into a company that could easily go under because the guy running it is under criminal investigation and might end up in jail? I wouldn't think so. I know I sure as hell wouldn't invest any money in that. And I think that's really the message here. Do I think Donald Trump's going to jail? Unfortunately, no. Again, love to see it happen. Probably not going to happen. However, it still does remain a possibility. And as this group is already losing donors or investors, excuse me, people have pulled out because they don't want to be involved with Donald Trump in any way, shape, or form. They don't trust him. They've seen what he's done to his other companies, not just his private ones, but the few that he had that were publicly owned. He got in a lot of trouble one time for his hotels and casinos that were a publicly traded part of the company. And then he used that money, even though he had a board of directors, shareholders, all that, to buy one of his privately owned casinos at a highly inflated value. So that caused a lot of problems. And now the big problem is that he could go to jail. Investors, listen, I'm no economic expert. I'm no expert in investing by any stretch of the imagination. But I got to tell you, all the news that's been coming out about Truth Social since it was announced has not been good. Hell, even Marjorie Taylor Greene has lost thousands of dollars investing in this company already. The same is going to happen with you folks, except on a much higher level. Because she just put in 50 grand. You've poured in millions, 300 million to be exact. You're not getting that money back. I hope you understand that. That money is not going to come back to you, at least not in the amount that you had put in. You're going to get far less than that if you get anything at all. You have an opportunity to walk away from this, and if you were smart with your money, I think that's exactly what you'd do. Hey, thanks for watching. And if you want even more Ring of Fire, we encourage everyone to like, comment, share, but most importantly, subscribe. And don't forget, you can find me on all social media outlets at Farron Balanced.